weekly reward goes to the Frates. Everyone, I think, in this room knows the history of the Frates family and the phenomenal accomplishment that they have achieved, not only in this region in Massachusetts, but throughout the country. 27-year-old Peter was diagnosed with ALS, also known as Lou Gehrig's. They were told that there was no treatment, no cure, and the prognosis for the remainder of life was only 2 to 5 years. Just think about that for a minute, and think about what your reaction would be to that event, if it occurred to you or a member of your family. Because you could. And it could quite suddenly. Most people would react by withdrawing, right? By feeling that the world was unfair, had been wrong, that they had been wrong. The Frates family did not do that. Quite the opposite. They looked at this as an opportunity to do good in a major way. And for that, they deserve all of our applause. As you know, the Frates family traveled to and networked with CEOs, senators, congressmen, doctors, and governmental authorities. They testified in Washington, D.C., and many, many other places. They executed federal and local petitions regarding the important issues facing people who suffered from this disease. And most interestingly, they inspired the whole bucket challenge and challenged everyone to do something for the sufferers of ALS. And that, as you know, has gone viral. How many pictures have we seen? How many important individuals have participated in that, raising $220 million for the ALS Association and its global partners. Finally, is cured. It will be a lot better because of the Frates family. So, let's really give a round of applause.
Mom, and I'm going to say a couple words on behalf of our family. was a growing one. Ever since he was a young boy, I was told by teachers and coaches that Pete exemplified what a captain and a leader is. Pete may not have been the best one on the field, but he made others be the best they could be, a true leader. And when he was given this diagnosis, he once again talked to us like we were his team. He set a vision, just like every leader should. He knew what our skill set was, and he knew what we could bring to this disease. And he also knew that it was a challenge that needed to be met. So for the past 3 years, we have followed our leader, Pete Frates, and we've changed the world. One family sitting around a kitchen table who found themselves in life-changing for a minute and decided that it wasn't acceptable. I want to thank someone very special in this room, Jay Conley of Conley Brothers. Jay is a great friend of Pete's from BC, and now he is family. He has been our maintenance man. He has been Pete's best friend. He has done so much to support us. I also see so many old friends from John and my days in the business world and the business community on the North Shore. This art story, people want to make it about a viral social media campaign, and yes, that was the vehicle in which it took off. But it's about family, it's about love, and it's about community. And none of it happens without our friends and our supporters on the North Shore. We are the epicenter of the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge. And as Bill said, when the cure and the treatment for ALS comes along, they're going to look back to Boston and its communities, and they're going to say, they did it. Thank you. We are honored that you have honored us tonight, and we are eternally grateful for all the support that you have given our family. And Pete Frates, you, my man, are a hero. Thank you.